live from Los Angeles on this hashtag Thought Thursday. I'm so excited to welcome bestselling author Jon Gordon to the show. He's the author of The Coffee Bean, went straight to number one on Amazon. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
So we've got to know, what are these simple lessons to creating a positive change in your life?
Well, it starts with the coffee bean message, to know that you can be a carrot when there is hot water, right? We are living right now in a time of hot water, negativity, and the carrot gets weakened by the environment. When you put an egg into hot water, it gets hardened by the environment. But you put a coffee bean into that hot water, it transforms the environment. So it's impacted
and you
by
came
the environment.
Up with that? You came up with that. That
it's
is amazing.
It's a story that's been around for a long time.
Oh, but I'm supposed to know these things.
My co-author actually learned this in prison, Damon West. He was a football star, got addicted to meth. Then he's burglarizing homes, gets sentenced for 65 years in jail, gets out in 7. He's speaking to all these football teams now, talking about his lessons and the coffee bean lesson that changed his life, because he was taught this in prison, and then he was able to survive prison as a result of that. He transformed the prison he was in. He really impacted the people around him, so much so that he got out really early. Well, I was at Clemson speaking to the football team there, worked with them for the past 7 years. Damon had just spoke, and the coach said, "You need to talk to this guy, Damon. We just heard the most amazing message on the coffee bean." Mm. When I heard this idea of inside out, creating inside out, not allowing the outside to affect you, I thought, this is the perfect message for what we need right now in the world. And so I reached out to Damon. I said, "Let's do this book together." And so we wrote it.
But you don't drink coffee.
No, I do not drink coffee, which is very, very ironic.
So it doesn't have a lot to do with coffee, really.
No, it really is more about the transformation that happens. But a lot of coffee drinkers do love
it. So it has cute little illustrations. Tell us about what to expect. What are the illustrations all about?
The illustrations are really just to share this simple concept, because it's such a powerful message. Mm-hmm. We wanted to tell the story about a young man who's feeling a lot of pressure, a lot of stress in his life, tough times at home with his parents, has a lot of responsibilities at school, and he learns this message from his teacher. So we follow his life as a student, then he goes to the military, then he goes into the work world, then he rises up the ranks, becomes a head of marketing for a company, winds up then starting to teach this message and realize that's his life calling. Mm-hmm. And we follow him all the way till he's an old man now, and we see the impact he's had by learning the coffee bean message.
Yeah,
so the illustrations take us through his life journey.
Right. But
in our own journey
as well.
Let's
play a little devil's advocate, though, because your shirt says stay positive, and it's whatever, but I believe there's a little bit of a glitch in the system in the positive movement, in that we can't always stay positive. Like, when it's actually like our emotions are good, in that they guide us. Sometimes if we're feeling sad or off, they're telling us we're not living our truth and we're off course. Right. I mean, you get over here. So how do you tell somebody to stay positive without suppressing what is going on for them?
And I get that question a lot, because I do a lot of work with companies and sports teams around the idea of positive leadership. And what I say is, it's not Pollyanna positive. This is not about being fake. This is knowing that you will face challenges. You will face adversity, but pessimists do not change the world.
For sure.
Naysayers say you can't do it. Complainers complain about problems, but they don't solve them. Throughout history, it is the positive leaders, the believers, and the dreamers that do it. This show is a great example of that, of what you've created, right? People said it probably couldn't have been done, but you are now doing it. Mm-hmm. So it's knowing we're going to get down, but how do we turn it around? My daughter, who is now 21, she just turned 21, she often says to me, Dad, you need to read your own book. And so in those kind of days, right, I'll be having a bad day, busted, but you know, I'm having a tough day. How do I turn around right now? So I don't wallow in the negativity. You own it. You feel it, you embrace it, but then you move forward in a positive
way. Totally agree.
And love,
very well said.
Love casts out fear. So fear is really why we often are negative. So once you understand that, how can I bring love to everything I'm doing? Mm-hmm. And once you are a coffee bean, you then will create from the inside out with love, you will overcome the fear in the world.
Are you a coffee bean?
I am a coffee lover and a coffee I love it.
Jasmine's definitely a coffee bean.
I'm just sucked into what you're saying
here. A coffee bean. Jon, I'm very curious though, you know, we spoke about your partner's journey to discovering coffee bean life, right? And that power. What was your personal journey to discovering that?
Great question. So my wife almost left me when I was about 31, 32 years old. I was negative, miserable, and life was beating me down.
Oh,
stress and the fear, I was crumbling. And she said, if you don't change, like, we're over. I can't spend my life with someone who makes me so miserable. It was a huge wake-up call. And I agreed right in that moment to change. Wow. And I began this journey of taking thank you walks like we talked about in the beginning. And it was a thank you walk that was about 10 to 30 minutes. And every day I would say what I'm grateful for on this walk. And over time, those walks of gratitude turned into walks of prayer. And then from there, I started to change from the inside out. Then I started to get these ideas for these books. And I started writing these books. And now I've sold 4 million books. Wow. As a result, and most importantly, impacted people's lives as a result of changing myself first. But my wife gets all the credit.
Because, so I have to ask the most important question.
Yeah.
Does she drink coffee?
She loves
I love that.
Yeah, my wife is a coffee drinker. She
of
can't
course.
Function without
I
coffee.
Love only cool people drink coffee.
I'm not cool, obviously.
Thank you so much for your time, Jon, and congratulations again. Number one best-selling book, Coffee Bean, on Amazon. Please tell everyone, though, where they can also find and follow your personal journey.
Jon Gordon 11, at Jon Gordon 11. My website is jongordon.com. That's J-O-N. Gordon.com, Instagram as well, at J-O-N Gordon.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Stay tuned. We'll be back more in Good Morning LaLa.